How are we doing, Meng Bo? How are you today? How's the weekend been? It's been a while. Good to see you. Just how are things? How's the weekend been treating you?
Hello, Meng Bo. 好久没跟你做访问了啊！最近过得如何啊？最近一切都好吗？
啊，最近一切都好。然后就是在备赛当中嘛。
Yeah, I've been doing very good. I'm just focusing on my training camp right now. So yeah, I'm very happy to see you again too.
Yeah, awesome to hear. And I mean, do you get to do much like fun stuff on the weekends, or is it mostly like relaxing when you're not training and stuff like that?
当你不训练的时候，你在干嘛？就是老外很好奇说，那你在休息日的时候都会做些什么事情？
就是备赛的时候，然后休息就想在家里宅着。然后因为就想睡觉然后好好休息嘛，但如果说不备赛的话就喜欢出去逛一逛，然后其实我很喜欢唱歌，然后所以说就偶尔约几个朋友去 KTV 去唱歌。
Oh, okay, hey man, I just want to be a couch potato all day when I'm free and binge watching other people's fight. And one more thing,just sleep all day long because, you know, I'm so focusing on my training camp, so I'm so tired. I really need a lot of rest time. And the other thing is I enjoy singing. So if I'm finally feeling refreshed, I will go hang out with friends and we sing together, have some fun together, things like that.
Okay, sounds like a good time for sure. And any time for any new tattoos?
他问你说你现在还有去做一些新的刺青吗？还有去打一些新的刺青吗？
最近没有，因为就是时间不允许嘛。然后因为如果说要是新的话，就要很长时间去恢复它，所以说就时间不太允许。
Yeah, I really want to get a new tattoo. I want to get a new one, but I'm just so focusing on my training camp, so my coach doesn't allow me to do that because he thinks if I got a new tattoo, maybe it will be, I will be distracted. So yeah, so right now I just maybe get a new tattoo after the Empower event.
There you go. It can be a celebration of sorts because it probably wouldn't feel too good, you know, rolling on the mats or something right after you get a tattoo. Probably would kind of hurt a little bit, right?
Yeah.Right. 他说如果拿了新的 tattoo 的话，可能当你在那个店就是在打斗的时候，可能碰到的时候会有一点痛这样子，所以之后再拿比较好。
什么之后？
他说对，他说你之后如果比赛赢了之后拿了一个新的刺青，可以去庆祝一下，去选一个新的刺青也蛮好的。
对对对对对，是因为我也想过，就是想在大腿纹一个，就是弄一个自己，就是把我自己，然后背着万的胶带，但是现在万的胶带没到手，所以说我还再等一等。
Okay, I want to show you my new tattoo plan. I want to get a new tattoo on my side, and that tattoo will be my face and me, a whole me with the belt. So the day if I got the one championship belt, I will get the new tattoo me Meng Bo with the belt on my side. You'll see that.
Okay, there's a great idea right there. So look, hopefully we can make that happen, right? That would be really cool.
Cool.
How have things been though in China lately, Meng Bo, in terms of like, you know, we're trying to get back to normal in the world with all the virus stuff, unfortunately, but it's like, are things back to normal for the most part where you're living, or just what's it like in the everyday life in that regard?
Oh, Meng Bo, 那现在在中国一切情况都还好吗？疫情的状况还好吗？那你在西安目前状况 OK 吗？
目前就是国内的话，有几个地方就是它是分布爆发的。然后我在西安俱乐部就是也不外面跑，是可以的，还是很安全的。
Yeah, pretty much back to normal right now. A lot of people got vaccinated, so you can have fun everywhere. There's everywhere in China, not so many restrictions. Right now, I'm in Xi'an. It's a western city in China. It's very safe right now, but a couple of weeks ago, we got several positive COVID cases. So because I want to be healthy in this event, so my coach asked me to...just stay home or stay in the gym, not to go to so many places. So yeah, so okay, I'm and under the government's control, things mostly work out. So yeah, it's such a great relief right now. But I spend much of time in my gym and my home to stay healthy.
Right. Yes. Better to be safe than sorry. That's for sure. But I'm curious though, Meng Bo, like when you go out and you're just doing everyday things, like let's say you're going shopping or something at the mall or something like that. Are you at that point of popularity where you're from now to where you get recognized a lot? Does that kind of thing happen?
孟博，因为之前新华社也有拍过你的纪录片嘛，你觉得现在的话，之前那个新华社拍你的纪录片之后，你觉得现在的话是不是很越来越多粉丝了？那你的感受怎么样？这样子是不是越来越多人在追在社交媒体上关注你了？
确实是因为其实一个运动员对一个运动员来说，曝光率就靠这些媒体。然后所以说就特别感谢他们吧，然后能为我们做一些曝光，然后让更多的人知道我们，然后知道中国的搏击，我觉得这样挺好，特别感谢他们。
你说那个新华社那个嘛，就是有我记得是破100多万的浏览嘛，对不对？
啊，对对对对对。
Okay, okay. I don't want to brag, but the biggest news agency in China, aka 新华社, presented a short documentary called Warrior Women, Fight to be Heard on this year's International Women's Day. And on the leading athlete in this video, it's hit near 1.4 million views and more than 4,000 comments. So yeah, I'm so excited about that.Though it's not a very big number in China because we have billions of people, but I'm still very happy about that.
Yeah, that is very cool. And I mean, is that kind of weird? Like just knowing like, wow, I am getting pretty popular. I mean, did you kind of expect this when you got into MMA where like, you know, you're fighting on a big global stage now with one championship and all that kind of thing, but is it weird to, you know, have like that fame at all?
那老外问你说，你会觉得会不会有点不太习惯？因为在你加入 MMA 之前，他跟现在在万达之后，越来越多人认识你了。那你会觉得有什么不习惯吗？还是觉得蛮享受这样越来越多人认识你的感觉？
其实我还蛮享受这个过程的。然后对，因为之前，因为在之前小的时候，可能练这个东西也没有说是特别想要大家都知道我或怎么怎么样的，但是现在越来越往后，就想让大家都知道，就是全中国、全世界都应该知道中国有一个孟博。
Okay, actually, I'm really enjoying being a superstar, you know, because when I was a little kid, when I training in this.MMA discipline, I have no idea I will become famous one day. So right now, I really enjoy all the fans, and I hope one day, not only in China, all the people around the world in the globe will know there is a woman, MMA fighter, a female fighter called Meng Bo, and she is tough, she is dangerous.
All right, and I mean, since we last caught up, Meng Bo,You did have your birthday, so I want to wish you a happy birthday now. I know I'm a couple months late, but I'm curious, what did you end up doing to celebrate?
他祝你生日快乐 ，Happy birthday， 孟博。然后呢，他问你说你在生日的时候，他说不好意思，这么晚才跟你说生日快乐。那你在生日的时候有做什么庆祝自己生日的事情吗？
谢谢谢谢 ，Thank you。我。就是我过生日的时候，不是就是定的是5月28号比赛嘛，然后我过生日的时候正好是我在降体重，然后我的老板就带我们大家都去给我庆祝生日，然后他们吃我看着。
Okay, thank you for a happy birthday. I have to be honest with you because in my birthday, I'm actually preparing my event, the Impel event, because it's originally set up in May 28th. So on that day, my boss Wang Guan, he just bring on my day birthday. My boss Wang Guan just took all of us to a restaurant, and we have a very big dinner. A lot of good stuff to eat, but because I'm focusing on my training camp and I'm doing the weight cut process, so I just watching. It's a little bit sad, but I'm still happy, enjoying with all of my team and my boss. So yeah, I'm happy even though I can eat with them.
Right. That's a little bit of a bummer, but hey, at least you got to hang out with people and, you know, have some fun at all. But I mean, let's just talk about it now, Meng Bo, you know, the tournament and everything that's been happening. I've been very frustrated for you because I think it's safe to say in the situation of the cancellations and everything, you've had to go through like three different opponents. It's all been switched up for you. How has that, this whole process been for you to go through this and like not really know who you're going to fight? I mean, has it been frustrating? Just tell me a little bit about what the last couple months have been like for you.
孟博，因为这一次比赛就是你的对手一直在换嘛，可能大概好像听说换了三个人，那这段时间因为你的对手一直在换，那你会心里面感觉到有点沮丧吗？你怎么去面对这种对手不确定的状态？
没有，就是换对手对我来说没有就是很大的影响，因为我觉得对阵谁我的对手是谁都无所谓的，然后是谁的话，就是因为之前就是对阵的是摔柔系，然后后来找了一个战力系，但是我觉得其实无所谓嘛，因为之前我也练过就是防摔，然后如果再换到他的话，我还是说就是去针对一下自己的备赛，所以说无所谓嘛。
OK, thank you for this question. Yes, my matchup has been constantly changing recently, but it doesn't trouble me at all, not even in a slightest way, because I know no matter who's gonna stand in front of me, I'm fearless. Because, you know, at the first, my first opponent, she's good at grappling, and next opponent is good at stand-up fighting. But no matter who they are, I have to work on this, those strategy games. So yeah, no matter who they are, I'm fearless. That's what makes a true fighter is.
Definitely. And I mean, were you worried at all though at any point to where like, all right, maybe this thing just isn't going to happen because it got delayed and, you know, with all the change-ups, were you pretty confident that, you know, things would come through and you'd actually get to do this, which, you know, we're almost there now, so.
你中间有没有一点点稍微担心过，就是说啊，这个事情一直在改变，变来变去，会不会到后来打不成了？有中间有这么一点担心过吗？
我知道，就是我知道这个比赛是只是推迟了而已，但是他一定会举办的，所以说我不担心他会不会就是取消。
Okay, I don't worry about the event gonna be, I don't worry about the event gonna happen or not, because I'm sure the event is gonna happen. I'm pretty sure about that. I know, I just tell myself every day that it's gonna happen and it's gonna be finalized as soon as possible. So I'm happy the date finally set up and it's all finalized. So yeah, I'm just stay active for this fight.
Yes, I'm very excited for it to, you know, finally happen and all that. And getting Ritu again, who was your first opponent, so you lost out on her, and now you have her again. So I'm just curious, you know, I imagine you did see her last two fights when, you know, she beat Lin Heixin and had the loss to B Win. Just curious, you know, what did you think of those two fights that she had since, you know, you guys were originally matched up?
这一次你又回到打了瑞图了，然后瑞图的话之前有两场比赛，一场输了一场赢了，那你怎么看他这两场比赛的表现？
我觉得瑞图的进步很大，然后再者说他的就是因为之前他也是属于摔跤系嘛，所以站立的话一点也不好，然后对于现在来说我觉得他的站立也是有很大的进步的，所以觉得是一个有上升空间的一个运动员。对
哦、OK, 那他之前输给那个软臂会觉得就是也是很正常的是不是？
对，因为软臂对于软臂来说他是一个就是很全面的一个对手嘛，然后所以软臂也不是很好打，所以就是输了很正常，反正我觉得。
OK, 那现在如果是软臂现在都是瑞图来打你的话，就是你刚刚说他身体也变比较好的话，所以他就是你觉得现在你打他的话，你应该也是有办法把他打掉的吧？
对。
OK. That fight Ritu lost to B, I'm not surprised because I just know it's gonna happen because she's only good at wrestling at that time. But I have to say, Ritu really impresses me when she defeated Lin Heqin. Though Lin hasn't fought for over 2 years, she's still a great fighter. I can see that Ritu is well prepared to fight Lin. She put a lot of hard work on stand-up game. So Ritu now is a top fighter, good at wrestling, good at stand-up, but that doesn't bother me at all because I'm tougher than her.
Do you think that, you know, her having fought twice recently, does that help her or hurt her, you know, going into this fight with you? Do you think that, you know, maybe she should have just waited and saved her energy for Meng Bo?
OK, 那你觉得是因为接下来你就要跟那个瑞图打了嘛 9月3号 但是瑞图之前已经打了两场比赛而且两场比赛隔蛮近的 你觉得这样对瑞图来会对你是个有利的情况吗 你觉得瑞图还有力气打你吗
我觉得他在什么时候都没有力气来打我
I don't think his energy is much more powerful than me because no matter how long she got rest or no matter how many times she got, I just can finish her easily, effortlessly.
All right, there we go. Looking forward to seeing it, of course. But, you know, it's interesting, Mengbo, with, you know, you having gone through all the opponent change-ups and everything for the tournament and now landing back on Ritu and all of that. I'm curious what your thoughts are on, you know, there's always this debate in MMA about if the sport is more of a physical sport or more of a mental, or maybe, you know, if there's a perfect balance. I'm just curious, where do you think the scale kind of is in terms of it being more mental or more physical?
就是在MMA这项运动里面，大家都觉得说，他不只是要身体很强壮，可能心理也要很强壮，然后就心理素质也要很好。那您怎么看MMA这个运动在身体跟心理素质的要求？你觉得它的重要性在哪里？
训练型运动员，一种是比赛型运动员。比赛型运动员的心理就很强大，然后训练型运动员就是心理不强大，他心理不强大的话，他上场比赛就打不出他训练平时训练的那种状态。然后，但是比赛型运动员他心理强大的话，他在场上他不害怕、不紧张，他就能把 平时训练中就能发挥到80%以上，就已经很不错了。所以你是觉得心理的强大更重要，对不对？我觉得心理强大最重要。OK，
if you ask me about the mental part and the physical part, I would say that mental part is much bigger importance than the physical part. Because for me, I think there are two types of athletes. One is only strong in their physique, and the other kind is strong on their mind. When they're strong on their mind, they can put on a much greater show than the physique strong ones. Because their mind is strong, so they don't fear, they're fearless, and they know how to deal with all kind of situation in the ring, in the circle. So yeah, so for me, I think mental strong is much more, way more important than physical part and physical strong. And I am the one that is mental very strong, mental strongly of a man.
Absolutely. And, you know, I'm curious, has there been maybe a moment that you kind of remember it stands out for you where something that you really had to overcome in terms of mentally pushing forward and continuing to go through whatever it was, maybe it was in a fight, maybe it wasn't. Is there some kind of moment that you had that you're really proud of, you know, yourself for getting through that mentally?
那你觉得心理比较强壮吗？你觉得心理强大这个数值很重要？那你有没有什么印象是你觉得说你透过你的心理的强大数值来克服过难关的？
我觉得应该就上次你那个受伤那个时候吧，对不对？对对对对对，就是因为如果说一个运动员要是真的没有就是一些价值了，或者是受伤了，或者是怎么样的，都会靠自己的心理去说服自己去坚持下去。那你要不要讲一下，就是那时候你那个就是受伤时候遇到的事情的，让你可以重新强壮起来那时候的故事。
就是那时候是遇到什么啊，关在小房间的事情我想到了。
对对对，因为上次比赛就是那个受伤嘛，然后所以说
那时候是发生了什么。
特别特别想放弃嘛，然后就后来就自己的心理比较强大一些，就是站在搏击这边就是比较多一些，所以说就坚持了下来，就把自己走出来。
就是我知道，就是那时候我就说你那时候关在小房间那个事情，对不对？
对对对对对对。
好 ，OK， I have got some injuries in the MMA fight about like past years, and after the fight, I forgot the year. It's maybe 2018 or 2017. Sorry, I forgot about that year. But that fight really got me a lot of injuries. So I'm so sad. I'm think maybe I'm doomed. I'm screwed up. I can't fight anymore. I locked myself in a very dark little room, and I don't want to step outside my room. But in that very dark time for me, I just think to myself, what should I do? Can I continue this fighter path? And after that low start day, what I learned is you have to be mentally strong, because the key point is my family and my friend and my team, they gave me a lot of support, and they made me believe I can be a true, good, great fighter. Like people say, a goat fighter, great of all the time. That's why I can now continue on this path and make it to the Grand Prix.
Definitely some good things to remember and continue to fight for. And, you know, on that note, I was curious, actually, like, when you're doing training and preparing for a fight specifically, like a fight camp, are you generally somebody who likes to train with, you know, the same people? Of course, you have that familiarity, maybe a little bit of a family type vibe. Or do you kind of try to mix it up a little bit, bring in new people depending on opponents? Or, you know, how is it when you prepare for a fight generally with your training partners?
Okay, 孟博，那像你现在就是你经历过这段时间之后，现在变得越来越强大了。那在你越来越强大之后，你在准备你的备赛期间，你会按照不同的对手来选择练习的对象吗？还是你有特别跟什么人一起做练习？比如说这一次。
对，我有专门的陪练，然后就是按照我对手的风格去给我陪练。
那这一次有特别选谁吗？特别谁跟你陪练的？我记得你说是王冠吗？
对，就是我的师哥就给我针对一些就是地面，然后或者是龙边的一些技术细节。
For every different training camp, my fight camp, I will, my coach and my team will, like you said, it will mix up. Like if I know my opponent is good at stand up fighting, I will find someone who is good at stand up fighting. And if my opponent is good at ground game, we will mix up someone that is really good at ground game. So help me in my training camp. For example, this time, my boss, Wang Guan, he's a former UFC fighter. He has been training my ground games all the time during recent days. And my coach has designed some special game plan, but I can share with you right now. So you'll see it in fight night. Just sit tight and watch my show.
Yeah, of course. I wasn't going to ask for you to reveal any secrets or anything, but I was just curious, of course. So, also, Meng Bo, you know, since we did last catch up, I'm sorry to bring her up, but I'm very curious what you thought of Weili Zhang's fight, you know, Zhang Weili, her last fight with Rose Namajunas, where, you know, she had her second loss, you know, somebody else beat her, not just you now. I'm curious if you saw the fight, what'd you think about it? And, you know, going back to the mental stuff, you know, something that she's got to overcome now is trying to get her belt back. Just curious your thoughts on that whole fight, if you saw it.
孟博，那你有没有看就上一次张伟丽跟 Rose 的比赛，你看了之后你的感受如何？那你对于他们接下来要在比赛的话，你的看法怎么样？
看完他俩的比赛，我觉得就是挺沮丧的，然后也挺遗憾的，然后因为就是一开始也没有看到他俩就是真正的对阵的在一起到底是什么样子，就是一开始就已经结束了嘛，所以我也很期待他俩二番战的时候，我觉得能好好打满吧，我觉得。
那你觉得 Rose 就是你觉得他的对手 Rose 是一个什么样的对手？
技术很，就是很全面的一个运动员，所以他的站立比较好嘛，因为他是属于拳击系。
我记得你那时候也说他打的位置很好嘛，对不对？很聪明。
就是变现腿
OK。
法，打得很聪明。
I feel so sorry for Zhang Weili because I know she must have been training super hard for that fight to defend the belt. She must have bear tons of pressure under the title of the first ever UFC Chinese champ. So, yeah, I feel so sorry for her. That fight only like 10 seconds or like less than 30 seconds, right? So yeah, I'm so sorry about that. I have to say that I feel a little disappointed. A fun game
Definitely.
because yeah, you're training for so such a long time, but when you're on the circle in the octagon, you only get 10 seconds, and then everything ends, and you lose your belt. So I'm so sorry for that. And I have to say that Rose is a talented fighter, and the way she kick and the spot she chose, it's just so right to the point. And yeah, so I heard you think like they're gonna have rematch end of this year. I'm really looking forward to it, and I hope they can go whole 3 or 5 rounds this time, not like 10 seconds last time. So yeah, of course I'll send all my best and cheer for Zhang Weili.
I know that was kind of the sad part. It's like we didn't really get a fight, you know, it was over so quickly that it would be great to see
Yeah,
them
so
actually go
quickly.
for a good while. So hopefully, yeah, that we could see that at some point. But you know, it's interesting because the story of that fight was kind of like how a little bit the location where, you know, Weili was going to America and the audience was kind of against her and all that. And for you in your career, Mengbo, like it's been mostly just China and Singapore, right, with the one championship fight. So you haven't really had to experience kind of too hostile of crowds yet, right? But I'm curious, you know, do you kind of have desires to travel a bit more and, you know, fight all around the world when we can, a little bit easier, obviously, than right now?
OK，那现在的话，孟博，因为现在主要你的比赛的话都是在新加坡为主嘛，都要去新加坡的 One 比赛。那如果之后有机会的话，你会想要去到很多地方，各个国家不同的地方去比赛吗？如果 One 有在其他地方各不同地方去办比赛，你会想要去比赛吗？还是说，就是你觉得，哎，其实就是现在待在家里也不错，就当可以不需要这么多限制的时候，你会想到处去走走吗？
对，很想，因为去新加坡这次已经是第三次了，也都是一直在隔离，然后也没有新加坡，就新加坡都没有去外面走走，所以说特别想要就是等不这样限制的时候，各处去走走。
Okay. Yeah, I want to travel around the world, no matter where the fight is, because this is my third time in Singapore. And every time I'm in Singapore, it's a long time quarantine. And after the quarantine, I get into the circle. So I fight, and after the fight, I fly back. I just fly back to China. So I have no idea what Singapore looks like. You know, I really want to have fun in Singapore. So after the COVID, after the pandemic, if no restriction, I want to travel all around the world to have a lot of fun.
Oh yeah, of course. I can't wait to do that myself. And Singapore is definitely a great place to explore. So once you get the chance to do that more, I recommend doing it. But outside of Singapore and just the world, do you have a spot or a country or somewhere you're really, you know, you really want to go to at some point that's, you know, more than others?
For fun or for fight?
Either one.
OK，那除了像，因为现在你最常去新加坡嘛，如果说你可以去很多其他国家，现在就是没有那么严格限制的话，你会想去哪个国家玩？你最想去哪个国家？然后为什么想去那？
我最想去菲律宾吧，
啊？为什么？
然后，因为我常在就是社交软件上刷到菲律宾的海特别清，然后那边的人特别友好，所以说挺想过去溜达溜达。
你是在哪边刷？是在抖音刷的吗？
对。
OK，if there's no, if the pandemic is over, I want the first country I want to travel is Philippines, because I have I play Douyin. Douyin is the Chinese version of TikTok, and I see a lot of Philippine video, travel video, and the sea ocean there is so blue, so clear, and the people is so nice, so friendly there. So yeah, if the first choice, I will choose Philippines.
Yeah, Philippines would definitely not be a bad vacation spot or anything like that. So good choice there. But as for kind of China though, Meng Bo, and I'm, you know, going back to the early days in your career when you were starting out and beginning, you know, when you were beating Zhang Weili and all that stuff. I'm curious, what do you remember the most about that time period in your life and in your career and, you know, fighting on kind of the China regional scene compared, especially now, to one championship and the bigger scale? Just what do you remember most about starting out?
孟博，你觉得打到现在啊，就是这么多比赛你都打过，你觉得对你来说啊，印象最深刻有什么事情吗？不管是最深刻的比赛，或是发生让你印象最深刻的事情，有什么吗？
就是打第一场万的时候吧，然后最深刻的就是我那一拳就是 KO 了对手，因为在这之前我也没有就是说觉得自己的战力水平不是很好，其实没有那么大的自信。就自从那场比赛把对手 KO 了之后，我就是信心很大。哎，那一场记得是第几回合？第几回合
KO 啊？那一场第二还是第一？ 我忘记了。I would say it's my first event in one championship, because before that event, I think, just like I said before, I experienced a long time injury, no fight, so that's the time. So I'm mentally strong. After my mentally strong, I go to one championship and I got that fight, my very first fight there, and I knocked out my opponent in the very first round, and I knock him out by my strike, by my punch, and it's a very powerful strike. So I got all my confidence back. I know I can continue on this fighter's path. So it's so memorable.
Definitely a very good win and performance for the highlight reel that you had in that one, for sure. So yeah, makes sense there. But all right, Meng Bo, this has been awesome as always when getting to catch up with you. So I will leave you with two last things and two kind of more fun questions, because that's always how, you know, it's fun to close out things with fun. So the first one I got for you here, I'm very curious, because I'm sure fighters maybe have similar answers for this question, but I don't know. You tell me here. When it comes to doing media and talking to people like me and, you know, all that kind of stuff, what's your least favorite part about it?
孟博，对你来说啊，就是你觉得最令你会觉得说啊好烦哦，就是啊接受的采访里面让你会觉得最烦的事情是什么？或者在这种媒体的采访里面？我觉得没有烦的时候吧，就是只不过就是降体重的时候，然后被采访脑细胞不够。
Okay, I enjoy all the media part, but one thing I really don't like is if media do the interview during the weight cut process, you know, it's so, you know, weight cut is, it's a really, you know, it's a, actually it's a bummer, because I can lead. I have I focus on the diet. So every time when I do interview during the weight cut, I just feel like I can express myself clearly. So that's probably the part I don't like it.
Totally understandable. And I don't know why they do that either. I feel like it should be the week before at earliest, right? Because we shouldn't be bothering you guys when you're weight cutting. No, it's no fun for anybody.
Yeah, I'll tell my company too. I'll tell my headquarters too. Yeah, don't do that during weight cut. Yeah.
Of course. But all right, Meng Bo, I will leave you with one last thing here. And the most important question, just got to know, if you had to be either a dancer or a singer for your career, which one would you pick and why?
Okay. 如果你要可以选择的话，当跳舞，就当舞者，跟当唱歌的人，就当歌手，舞者跟歌手，你会选哪一个？
舞者，就是武术的舞。
没有没有，跳舞的舞，跳舞可以当跳跳舞跟歌手，就去跳舞跟歌手，你会选哪一个？为什么？
歌手，因为我觉得我跳舞不协调。
Okay, I'll choose to be a singer because I really enjoy singing. Like I said before that, when I have free time, I'll go out and singing with my friend. I go to play KTV. I don't know. I'm not quite sure the English name in KTV. I'll translate that later for you. And I don't want to be a dancer because, you know, though I'm a very good fighter, but I'm pretty bad, lousy at dancing. So yeah, I'll choose singer. I want to be a singer.
All right, there we go. There's a fallback plan for you. You know, at the end of the fighting, you can become a singer. No, just kidding. But all right, there we go. Very cool, Meng Bo. Well, this was great. You know, thank you so much for taking the time. We'll let you get on with the rest of your day now and your Sunday, right? So I appreciate it always. Big shishi to you. And I wish you the best of luck, you know, for the tournament and all that stuff. We'll be watching. Can't wait for it. Going to be fun. Just can't wait to see you back. So I wish you all the best and hope training goes smoothly up until then. Safe travels, all that stuff. Just thanks so much for catching up.
好，谢谢，谢谢，辛苦了。我很荣幸，我很荣幸接受你，那个接受你的采访。
因为觉得他很可爱吗？
对对对对对。
Okay, thank you for this interview. I really enjoy your interview because every time you always surprise me. So I'm looking forward to your next surprise.
Of course, always got something up my sleeve.
Bye.